Hi guys, very good evening to you. Welcome to the video number 218. And in this video number 218, we are going to talk about the for next loop, which we use a lot in Excel VBA. And this is going to be the part 3 of this video. And in this video, we are going to, jump on from the basic level to the intermediate level. As you can see here, that we are going to actually write the loop 2 times in a single code, right? So for those who are watching my channel for the first time, let me just tell you, you can watch all those 217 videos on my channel, and this is the playlist where we have got all these videos. You can scroll it down, and I'm sure whatever subject you want to actually have a look on, if you are stuck somewhere, you need some understanding on that, you can go there and you can find out a lot of videos with the different examples. So we have Excel, we have Excel VBA, and we have Access, and we have Access VBA. So everything we have actually combined, and you can go through all these lists one by one, and you can see that what exactly you're looking forward to. So recently we have started a for next we have started basically a series on the loops, so that to give you the understanding. Now if you click on this Excel VBA loops example series, you would find here that I've uploaded almost 11 videos, right? And there is a video number 217 as well, which I had uploaded couple of hours back, and you would find here when you're going to watch this video, you would be finding it out here. So right now I can't show you because I haven't actually uploaded it on my channel, but that is a part two. So if you need any understanding on the for next loop in the Excel VBA, then please go ahead and watch this part one and then the part two. This is going to be the part three, and in this case, what exactly we are going to do, we're going to actually form this kind of a loop. Now these are the loops, guys, which when you go for the VBA interviews, then these guys ask you to make the different the patterns in the loop, and this is one of the pattern which I have picked up, right? Trust me, this pattern can also be asked in your VBA interview, right? So this is more of a VBA preparation, preparation for the interview as well. Not only that, we are going to discuss about the for next loop, but also you can practice on it, because if you are going to appear for any interview, if you have any plans in the near future, this is going to give you a lot of insight on this, right? Okay, so now how are we going to do that? Let me come to the sheet 2, and in the sheet 2, let me click on the Visual Basic, and let's just insert the module, and in this module, let me just write here loop pattern. So how are we going to do that, right? Now first thing, let me just clear it out. If you really want to have the good understanding on for next loop, then please go ahead and watch the part 1 and then part 2, because they have really explained a lot that what are the VBA keywords and how do we basically write this syntax. In this video number 3, we are not really going to discuss about the basics, though I will be telling you a little bit about this, but the more focus should be on the the code which we are actually supposed to prepare, the the pattern which is supposed to prepare. So when you write anything in the VBA, this is how you use the word for, and then you declare any variable here, I equals to how many times you want to run, this is how you define, and then you write the next. So what happens, this loop is going to run now 5 times, and whatever you write inside this for and next, that is going to be here, whatever you're going to write here, that is going to be executed 5 times, right? As I said, if you want to watch it from the beginning, just after this video, you can go back and watch those part 1 and part 2 videos. So now what exactly we want to do, so I'm going to declare here as long. Now look at the the pattern what we want to do. So basically, if you look at the pattern, the first thing which is happening here is that every value is getting incremented by 1. So we can say that values are being incremented by 1. Pardon me for the spelling mistakes. And the next thing is that what we want to do, the moment you reach to the 5, basically your columns are decreasing. However, your rows are still incrementing, right? So this is the big change from the last 2 videos. So what happened on reaching the value 5, okay, columns are decreasing and your row numbers are still increasing, right? They are still increasing, because you see that from the very beginning, actually the rows are incrementing like this. We have 1 here, we have 2 here in this row, and then we have 3 here, and then we have 4 here, and then we have 5 here, and then we have 6 here, right? So whenever you are asked to prepare any kind of a loop, right? Whether it's your interview or whatever, right? It really doesn't matter. What matters is just observe the data. After all, you know, Excel is all about doing the analysis, right? And Excel VBAs, I mean, whenever you write the code, you always are full of logics, you know, you always keep on thinking. You have to think, actually, right? Because VBA is all about thinking, right? So the good you can think, you know, the better will be results. So in this, as I said, that these are the basically, you know, two things. And there is a one more important thing, that how many times we are supposed to run this loop. So we can do one thing. Now, there are n number of ways. The way I'm going to tell you about this, how to prepare this loop, maybe not that good, you know, as you can think of. So I would definitely like to hear from you. You can tell me, you know, you can share your own VBA codes as well, if you are going to make any of the code, because this can be done in n number of ways. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to first run this loop 5 times. I'm going to, you know, print all these values one by one. And in the next loop, I'm going to actually prepare another loop, and then I'm going to run, you know, this the second time loop, right, in the same macro, of course. So let's go ahead and let's start. So the first thing which I'm doing is that I know that it has to stop at 5. So let's go ahead and first of all, let's actually display all the values one by one. So here I'm going to write cells, row number and the column number. Two variables I'm taking. Equals to, the value has to be equals to, let's say I'm going to declare here as I, because you know this I is going to increment one by one, so I can make a use of this I. So this is entirely different thing this time I'm doing from the last two videos. There we, instead of declaring the I, we declared some another variable. So I'm actually using I not only for the loop purpose, that it should run 5 times, but at the same time I'm also going to use this value in publishing these numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, right? And before I start, let me just also write the sheet name. So I'm going to be on the sheet number 2, so I just use the index, or you can also use quote, and then you can write the sheet name, which is sheet 2. All right, so now let's go ahead, and obviously you would like to declare these row numbers as well. So I'm going to declare this as a byte and column number is byte. Why I'm declaring as byte, because just to, you know, tell you, give the clarity, that because I know that this value cannot, you know, is not going to hold a value more than 0 to 255, so I'm using these as byte. If you have any doubts about the data type, please go ahead and watch my video on the, you know, the VBA interview questions on the data types, you would understand what I'm saying. So byte means that it can hold 0 to 255 value, and it is really not going to, you know, put much of the load on your, you know, the hard disk on your computer's memory, right? So that is why I'm using it. Otherwise you can use long, integer, whatever you want to use, right? So now the next thing which I want to do is the row number, obviously I want to increment by 1, because you see that once we have the value here 1, the row number next time should go here. So we should be incrementing the row number, and we should be having the value called 2. And in the same way, I should be also writing the column number, and it is going to be the column number plus 1, right? So once you do that, let's go ahead and let's first run this, and let's see that if we are going to write this or not. So there we go, I'm on the sheet 2. Now the row number 1, what is the value in the row number 1? It is going to give you the error, because object defined error, right? Why? Because this is empty right now. So in the Excel, you don't have an empty row, right? So you have to start it with 1, and then you have to start it the column number also as 1. So now let us go ahead and run this. Now if you run this, you see that row number is going to give you a value called 1, and the column number is also going to give you the value 1. And which is why, you know, you're able to see this value, the I value is 1, because I is actually, we have started this I as 1, right? You can also, let me just on the local window also. Local window is a basically tool, it's a window where you will have all the variables, and you can have a watch on that, right? So this is what exactly is happening. You can see now the row number is going to be incremented. You can see here that row number is incremented by 2. Then you have a column number also incremented by 2. And I have already explained this in the previous videos. So now the row number 2 and the column number 2 is going to pick up the next value of the I, because the loop is running the second time, right? So that means that on the A2 cell, on the B2 cell, I beg your pardon, you're going to have a value called 2. Again, I'm going to increment the row number. So this we have already done, right, in the previous chapters. So let's just simply run this. Now when you have this loop finished, as you can see 5 times it has run, the next thing which you want to do here is you're going to run this loop again. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to say that for I equals to again 1 to 4, because I need the value here, you know, till 9. So 5, and then here 6, 7, 8, 9. So it should run only 4 times, right? And then next, And before it starts, what exactly we want to do? Yeah, now you see guys, here we have a row number called 6. So we want to go to the row number, which row number? Obviously 6 row number, right? But the column number should not be 7 or the 6, it should be 5. So here what you're going to do, you're simply going to decrease the value of the column number. Okay, so I'm gonna minus 1 it. However, the row number will remain as it is, I believe so. Let's just go ahead and let's see. So I'm going to copy this value and here I'm going to paste the value, right? Now since you're starting this loop again from I equals to 1 to 4, so here I will again have a value called, you know, 1. So you don't need the 1 here, right? Because your loop, if you look at the example, it should be 6, 7, 8 and 9. So what we are going to do here is, in that case, we can do one thing. We can declare one, maybe, you know, a variable, let's say myval, and we can declare this myval in the top, myval as long or whatever you want to call it, maybe byte. And then let me just reset the code, and here then before we run this, after this loop, you know, when you're going to enter in the next loop, we are going to increment this, we are going to start this value with the 7 6, you know, and then once the loop starts, 1 2 3 4, because it is supposed to run 4 times, I'm going to actually increment it by 1, right? So in this way I can run this loop. Now let's have a look on this, and at the same time don't forget to make this dynamic, because every time you need to go to the, you know, the previous column. So you should be subtracting minus 1 from it every time, right? And at the same time your row number should be incrementing, because you would like to go to the next row number. So you know, so this is a little, actually, you know, I would say intermediate level of a loop actually. So that is why I said that if you have any challenges in knowing the concept of the, you know, for next loop, you can go ahead and start from the series 1, the part 1, right? So let me just delete everything and let's just have a run on this code again. Okay, so now let's just go ahead and run. Variable not defined. Alright, so I haven't defined actually. Alright, so this is not my val, but this is my underscore val. Okay, let's go ahead. Alright, so this, we already know that this is going to publish all the values one by one. There's no doubt in that. Now once you see that we have run this loop 5 times, the next time I want is, what is the value in the column number? It's 6, right? So if you look at this, 6 means that you're going to be on the F column. But you don't want to be on the F column, right? You want to be on the D column. So basically you should subtract 2 from it. There we go. Now what is the column number? The column number is 4, which means that it is going to print the value on the column D, right? So my val, I have allocated this number as 6, because this is what exactly we're going to use here. Now let's run this and have a look. So what is your row number right now? So guys, row number is 6, which is perfect. This is the row number 6. And the column number is going to be 4, which is this. So that means it should be your column called D6. So let's have a look here, and you can see here that we got the 6, right? Now once your cursor, I mean your value, it prints on the 6, the next time what you want to actually further go down, and at the same time your column should also decrease. The column actually should decrease because you are moving in the, you know, backward direction, but the row number should increase, right? So that is why I said row number should be incremented by plus 1 and the column should be decreased by minus 1, right? And at the same time, this value which we have right now showing up as 6, it should be going to be incremented so that we can have here a value called 7. So let's just run this. Now you see that my val has 7, the column number is now 3, which means that I'm talking about the C column, C as in cat, right? And that's row number. Let's have a look on the row number. So row number is going to be 7. So row number 7 and the column number 3, it is going to be a C7 cell, definitely. So let's go ahead and let's see. And there we go. You got the 7 here, right? And then you keep on running this and you see that 8, and then last time it is going to run, you have a 9 and the code finishes. So in this way, you can prepare this kind of a loop. So And if you prepare this kind of a loop, definitely I'm sure the person is going, you know, taking your interview or whatever. I mean, if somebody is asking you for this kind of a stuff, then definitely they will be impressed, because here you have used the two different loops. Right now, there are a number of ways, you know, further making it dynamic, and there are a lot of other, you know, the ways, as I said, there are several ways, you know, you can use it, but it is just one of it. I have shared it with you, right? So I guess this that's it, and so this is the part 3. Don't forget to watch the previous parts as well, and if you haven't subscribed to the channel, as usual, I request you to subscribe to the channel. You have a link on the bottom corner, and we are going to, you know, have some more examples in the coming videos. Thank you so much, guys, and have a very, very happy learning. Bye bye.